Hey guys, I am Big and Scary. I'm bringing you another StarCraft 2 replay. This time it's game 6, I believe, in the clan war between Tag, the Donut. Just Tag. Clan Tag versus Clan NON Esports. Tag is Team Awesome Gamers. The Donut is our red Protoss in the bottom right-hand side of Cactus Valley. He is a Masters level EU Protoss and is currently on a one-game winning streak, having taken game 5 from NON Esports. Making it so that Team Awesome Gamers is actually in the lead by just 1 point. Representing NON Esports is Forsaken XE, our purple Terran at the top right-hand side. He's going to need to take out not just this win, but the other win in order to clinch the victory in this best-of-seven clan war. So it's very exciting. Exciting times. The Donut had a really, really cool play. Last game, he had a bit of a Stargate all-in with some Void Rays. I thought it was just a proxy going to go into an Oracle, but it got scouted early on. Really nice adaption, switching over to those Void Rays. Maybe it was something he intended from the very beginning. I'm not 100% sure. It looked like he was just being a very, very typical, aggressive kind of Oracle opening, but in reality, he transitioned very well into another build, and it was great. It was really, really great. I enjoyed it a lot. We see the Rax first coming down from Forsaken, and a Refinery following immediately thereafter, so he's going to be opening with that very typical Reaper scouting build. No surprises there. No gas being tapped just yet for the Donut. Remember, he did grab double gas very early on in the last game, so we'll keep an eye out for that, see if there's going to be any shenanigans. He is scouting in the correct direction, so he's going to find Forsaken very, very quickly. And I don't think... No, Forsaken didn't scout with an SCV at all, so he has no idea where his opponent is, just for the time being. We got time, though. We got time. He's got all the time in the world. Single gas tap, gateway. Really nothing going on. I mean, nothing exciting, nothing brand new. Rax finishes, Orbital Command's probably going to start immediately, and there goes that first Reaper that I was talking about. So yeah, both players kind of transitioning down that very typical pathway that we've come to expect, really. SCV, unfortunately, moving in the clockwise direction, so he knows exactly where he's going. I wonder why. I mean, obviously he's going to throw down a pylon or something over here, or keep this guy kind of far afield. I wonder if it's going to be another proxy play. I don't think so, because we don't have that double gas being tapped, but hey, only time will tell. Maybe he's just keeping his probe in the area so that he can poke back in and scout again later on. Yeah, I'd say that's probably typical. Have that first Cybernetics core finishes, probe moving down with the 400 minerals, going to be throwing down a Nexus on the low ground, CC already on the low ground, so both players kind of teching along that relaxed path. I mean, neither one is going to be overly aggressive, neither one is going to be overly frisky, because this guy hasn't thrown down that pylon. This Reaper is going to be getting into the main base really, really in a short order, and we see that the Mothership core being chrono boosted out will be popping out just in the nick of time to start doing some damage to that Reaper. But the Reaper gets in there, sees that one Vespin Geyser is not tapped, so he's going to be feeling good about that. Doesn't see any pylons missing, does he? Two pylons there. Yeah, I guess with the Nexus on the low ground, he's not missing any pylons just yet. 4:30 is kind of a weird timing for that. SCV, poor little SCV, he's going to be heading home. This probe is still not doing anything, and he doesn't know. He doesn't know that command center went on the low ground, does he? No, he does not. Didn't even see it being thrown down or anything like that. I feel like he'd probably want to move back in just to see, poke up that ramp, see what's going on with that command center. Otherwise, you're kind of in the dark. I mean, obviously, he knows what he's doing. He's getting that Nexus down. There goes the pylon. Fantastic. And that's with Warp Gate about halfway done. No gateways being thrown down, though, so it's not like it's going to be something uber, uber aggressive. I guess he's still got a little bit of time left for him to throw down those gateways if he really, really wants to. But no, choosing for a robotics facility instead, a very safe opening. Still just one gas for Forsaken. We see that 111 opening up. Just a reactor, though, no tech lab coming out from the factory or anything like that, so maybe not a Banshee harass, more likely. Getting out some Widow Mines, maybe some Hellions to do a run by, but Widow Mines are so good against... Yeah, there we go. Widow Mines are so good against Protoss, just with their extra damage. You can do some really, really significant damage. I'd love to see a Medevac coming out from that starport, loaded up with a couple of those Widow Mines, and then just do some wicked awesome damage to the mineral line. But we'll see. That Reaper's still just giving him some fantastic knowledge. I mean, he gets in there, sees the robotics facilities up, sees the gateways up. What is he fighting? Just a little bit of a skirmish between those two Stalkers. But again, with that Widow Mine there, these Stalkers have absolutely no hope in the world to cracking this. What with all those Marines, plus the Widowmine back at home, Medivac going to be popping out to heal up those Marines, so a really nice, solid defense, really not a lot that Donut, not a lot that he expected to be able to do, frankly. I mean, he was just poking at the door, keep his opponent honest, keep his opponent contained, just on three bases, let him know that he's there. Observer coming out, saturation at the Naturals looking pretty good, all four gases now tapped, Forge already up too. Ooh, Photon Cannon the main. I wonder if he's concerned about, you know, the drop play. Two Widow Mines are going to get shut down pretty quickly, especially with the route that he's taking. It looks like he's going to be popping in here just whenever that Photon Cannon finishes, and with the static detection there, there's really not a lot that we expect these Widow Mines to actually get done. So, yeah, a good play here by Forsaken just to realize that the gig is up. See if he can get one of his burrows, see if he can get one of those shots off. But no, Photon Overcharge also pushes that away. Really not a lot that drop could expect to do with the Photon Cannons already being thrown down. But hey, that's 300 minerals right there that was invested. And in reality, Forsaken only lost a single Widow Mine, so really not a wash for him. Again, just keeping your opponent honest, making it so that you can't cut corners and, you know, skimp on the defenses back at home. He wasted the energy of a Photon Overcharge, so that's always nice. And he's still got that Medivac flying around. He's still got the drop potential of that single Widow Mine. Robotics facility is going to be poking out the first Colossus of the game. We have plus one armor already being started, so really Donut is playing this for the late game. I mean, look at his army right now. Really paltry in comparison to Forsaken's. I mean, he's got quite a lot of Marines, more than a handful of Marauders being thrown into the mix. And I'm liking his infrastructure. I mean, it looks like he's going to be hitting his stride relatively soon. Don't see another CC being thrown down, so it looks like Forsaken is making motions like he wants to be aggressive. Let's look at his upgrades. Just plus one ground on the way. Combat shield and stem being started at the same time. I mentioned this earlier in the series that this is something I love to see because this thing hits like a ton of bricks. It's going to be hitting at about the 11-minute mark, which is very typical for Terran, but still a very powerful moment. Just two medevacs, yeah, because there's no add-on to that starport. Just whatever I was saying, that he's gonna be using the reactor on the factory, so gonna be pumping out those medevacs, making it so that your Terran bio army is just so incredibly mobile, which is really what you need in order to actually, you know, successfully combat this Colossus. Second Colossus on the way, plus one weapons also being started. Extended Thermal Lance, more than halfway done. So this is the time that Forsaken needs to get in. Is this going to finish before the 11-minute mark? No, it's not. And so it looks like Stim, Combat Shields, and plus one for Terran Army is going to be done before Extended Thermal Lance can come out. Probably before, no, about the same time this second Colossus comes out. Just four gateways, not a lot of meat on this ground army. So I would say that Forsaken, if he wants to feel frisky, he could definitely feel frisky. He could definitely get out there and start doing more damage. Did these guys do anything? No kills on those Zealots, but looks like they were successfully distracting the reinforcements from Forsaken. Third CC down on the low ground, and Forsaken's really not being aggressive with these guys. I'd love to see a drop off, you know, somewhere in here, maybe a run by. I mean, still just one Photon Cannon. You have to be very careful whenever you're dealing with Colossus because one or two volleys can really decimate your Marines, but he's got the upgrade advantage. At least he had the upgrade advantage. Thermal Lance is done now. Plus one is halfway done. Second Colossus is out. So that window has passed, and Forsaken realizes it. I mean, he's definitely retreated, probably because he was distracted by those Zealots just doing a run by. Another Marauder in the area is going to slow him down with his concussion shells and really just kind of repel any sort of harassment that Donut's going to be doing right now. So yeah, this is nice. This is really nice. I guess the Zealot got all the way into the command center for a couple of swipes, but that's about it. Look at this infrastructure back at home, by the way. I mean, this is absolutely a war machine. So many barracks, so many add-ons, lots of tech labs too. So he's going to have the ability to pump out a whole lot of Marauders. And we can actually see that he's beginning to transition away from making medevacs into those Vikings. He's got four Vikings out on the field just for the time being. Another little harassment with these Zealots, but plenty of Marauders in the area, really just making short work of them. At the same time, Donut looks like he's going to be moving out, finding another Marauder, canceling another pylon. But with three Colossi, this is going to be absolutely devastating. A little bit of a drop on the north side of the main. A lot of Marauders in here is going to make short work of that Photon Cannon and then short work of this mineral line. So we'll have to keep an eye on that. At the same time, Donut has positioned his main army over here at the junction between the main and the natural. Or the natural and the third, pardon me. there goes the recall to actually combat this heavy drop. And those marauders, at choosing instead to bypass the mineral line and rather focus down some pylons, depowering four warp gates, pardon me, and the robotics facility, or robotics bay. Not the most important thing in the world, but how, what sort of economic damage did he do? 42 over 63 for the harvester count. Wow, another little strike force. I guess this was that main drop, the drop that was in the main that lifted off because of the, will he get the Nexus? Wow, so close. So incredibly close, just barely getting the Nexus. That is a massive blow to Donut because he needs to be able to produce those harvesters three at a time in order to catch up to the harvester count. I mean, 42 over 63 right now. Forsaken's not making SCVs. He's happy with his saturation. I guess, did he lift off his third? He did lift off his third. I guess it was another little run by here, but it's been secured. Really has to take care of that pylon. It's actually a really good play for Donut to have that pylon in position. Donut is feeling the pressure. He needs to push out and do damage right now because of that economic hit that he took. Mothership Core does go down, but not without throwing out the warp, time warp on the low ground. The third has already been lifted off, much to the chagrin of Donut, because he'd love to get in there and actually do some damage. Note that Storm is almost done, and with those High Templar is going to be able to be warped in on the very close because of that proxy pylon. That's actually going to be coming into play relatively shortly. Blink, just about halfway done right now, and just a bit of a cat and mouse. I don't believe Donut has a force that's capable of actually cracking this. Storms would be fantastic because they would take care of all of those SCVs in really, really short order, and also can help to whittle down those Vikings. Blink, once it's done, those Stalkers will be able to do a whole lot more damage, but all things considered right now, I think that both players are going to have to sit back and stabilize. Supply count's relatively even. Harvester count has begun to stabilize, 47 over 54. More than a handful of the SCVs probably went down during that harassment, during that little push. I mean, those Colossi do a lot of damage. 9 workers killed to 17. So yeah, pretty even, all things considered. I mean, you look at the resources Lost have, pretty much neck and neck. I mean, you gotta remember that Forsaken's been mining off of this third base a lot longer and more constant than the Donut, and so even though Donut has his Nexus up right now, instantly the third is resaturated, and another pesky Zealot runs in here. I forget which one in the series had a bunker that was just fully saturated with 4 Marines here during that entire during their entire match. I forget who it was, but I thought it was a really, really cool play. Love to see more of it, and we actually see that bunker going down at the third. Vikings get absolutely shredded by the Stalkers underfoot, but they succeeded taking down one Colossus and another one deep into the red. Colossus count is just way too strong here, absolutely shredding through all these Stalkers. It looks like this third is totally going to go down. But Forsaken has lost a decent chunk of his army, so I think Forsaken's feeling fantastic right now. This third is definitely going to go down. Really, what remains to be seen is, will Donut be able to actually resupply off of this? Remember, he's got Storm, so that's something that can throw down a lot of splash damage on these heavily orange and yellow Marines, but with the medic count so high right now, they're quickly going to be healing them back up, so even one well-placed Storm is not going to be enough to bring down these heavily upgraded units. I mean, remember, this is just 1-1. I thought we were at 2-2. I guess 2-2 is plus 2 is finishing up. Not going to be finished before this engagement happens, though. Stalkers blink forward, trying to buy time for the Storm that does go down, does do some pretty decent damage, but just the Terran army is just way too strong. Another warp-in gets cut down very quickly. The last Immortal falls, and it looks like the Donut is going to have to tap out, making it so that Forsaken brings this actually to the ace match. This is the ace match. We're on game number 7 now, and it is currently 3-3. Tied up, so Forsaken, the champion of InnoWin Esports, takes down Team Awesome Gamers after his dominant display in the previous game. So that was actually really, really cool. And before I go, I wanted to mention that this bunker is what I was talking about. Look at that. Took quite a lot of damage. I would assume it was taking damage from maybe another run-by of a Zealot or something like that. Frankly, I'm not paying too much attention to that sort of harassment because there's no excitement there. It's just, will Forsaken realize that there's something there, and he moves his reinforcements over there. I should get in the habit of, you know, pointing it out whenever it happens in the minimap, but this is so much more important because that's actually how you win the game. You know who's winning at life is you guys, because you're watching my video, so thank you for that. If you have a game you want me to cast, you could send me the replay here or on Reddit. One way or another, I will see you guys later. I am Big and Scary.